I'm now going to do one of my favorite reactions. It's not very spectacular, but I think it's very satisfying. It's the reaction between hydrogen peroxide and potassium permanganate. Let's begin with a bit of water. So I'll add some potassium permanganate, which gives it a nice pinkish purple color. You've probably heard me saying already that my grandfather used to put permanganate in his goldfish tank so the fish would swim round in purple water. Didn't seem to do them any harm. We now add a little bit of sulfuric acid. The acid doesn't change the color at all. So you can see now we've got some nice purple potassium permanganate, and now we will take some hydrogen peroxide. Sam had a big bottle that she needs to be used up, and we'll add it and see if we can see anything happening. So watch carefully. I think it may be flat. I'll try another bottle. I'll get some of my own hydrogen peroxide instead. Yes. Well, hydrogen peroxide can decompose into oxygen and water. And if you keep it too long, it goes off. So I get some more. So we got some more. There isn't very much of it, but perhaps this will be enough. I'm not very impressed, are you?
It's not the best thing I've seen.
Hydrogen peroxide has the formula H2O2, and it has quite a strange structure. This is a model that I use for the students. I'm sorry, the atoms are all the same color, but you imagine this one and that one, the ones I'm holding with my hands, are hydrogens, and the two black ones are oxygen. And the important thing is you can see it has quite short hydrogen-oxygen bonds, and a very long oxygen-oxygen bond, which is weak and breaks very easily, which is what makes hydrogen peroxide so reactive. It also has this rather strange structure that this bond is at right angles to that one. If I hold it up, this one is horizontal and that one is vertical. And so it has a rather strange symmetrical structure. I once hit myself very hard on the nose while demonstrating this in a lecture. So you have a long oxygen-oxygen bond that makes hydrogen peroxide very reactive. Pure hydrogen peroxide will set fire to almost all organic matter. So if you put it on a piece of cloth, whoosh, it goes up in flames. So normally people use hydrogen peroxide as a dilute solution. And here you can see we have one solution which is called 40 volume, which means 1 liter of liquid gives 40 liters of oxygen gas if it decomposes. And this sample here, which you can see has more aggressive warnings, a bit more dangerous, this is 100 volume. And so the hydrogen peroxide that you buy in the chemists for bleaching your hair is much weaker. It may only be 5 or 10 volumes. So this is 10 times stronger. You wouldn't bleach your hair with this. It might go up in smoke. Trying again, this time I hope a bit better. I put warm water in here so the reaction may be faster. And I'll put in most of the acid as well. Then a bit of permanganate. And now that we've got enough peroxide still left, you can see it's decolorizing straight away. That's pretty cool.
What's going on there, man?
So what's happened now, I didn't wash the thing out properly and we had some peroxide left. And now it's reacting faster than we can add the permanganate. So this is actually much better than I intended, because I was going to make it purple and make it go clear. And here you can see I'm pouring in a purple solution and it's disappearing.
That's brilliant.
And you can see it's releasing oxygen from the hydrogen peroxide. So when it hits the surface, the manganese, which is bound to oxygen in permanganate, reacts and loses its oxygen and forms manganese ions, manganese 2+, for those of your chemists, which are completely colourless. So it goes from this very intensely coloured salt to the colourless one. So it's like magic, isn't it?
You have to remember this trick.
Yes.
Lovely. This wasn't what you wanted to show us.
No, but it's even better. I now have to explain to the technicians why I've used the whole bottle of permanganate solution.